Garageland on Cruinniú and on RTE2XM.
Welcome back to Garageland at Cruinniú and on RTE2XM and online and all over the whole world today, the 12th of June. I want to say a big thank you while we're here to young Ayanna here beside me, Ayanna Church, who you can see, Ayanna, how many pages are you going to have?
About 20, I'd say,
don't I? We were supposed to have about spaces for 45 young artists to take part in today's show, and the take-up was so good, we ended up having around about 100. Now, this is a couple of days before the event.
Yeah.
Still a few days to go.
Yeah, still a few days to go.
And we've just got a text from a mum, Melissa. Hello, Melissa, if you're watching on today. And we're, of course, still taking applications when we're not meant to be anymore. The day's gone crackers. We're up over 100. It's a lot of fun. And thanks to everyone concerned. And a big thanks again, Ayanna, for stepping in. First job as a presenter, you know. Who have we got in this section, Ayanna?
Well, we're going to hear from Gavin James and Craig Walker again, so our special guests. We're going to hear from Lily and Jean in Killarney, Mackenzie in Finglas for her second performance, I think it is. Yeah. And Beanath from Dublin.
And then we are also, because I have to remember some of the stuff as well, you see. So we're going back down to Rockwell Music Academy in Tipperary, and we're going to be visiting Alexandra Vossett in Ratcool, Anna Kearney in Dublin, John Carlos Estrella in Lucan, and Lisa Price Vocal Studio over in Tontar for more of the duets. And it's quite possible that on Saturday afternoon of the 12th of June at about 5 o'clock, we'll still be announcing names. And if that happens, it happens. Have fun.
You bring the stars out, and you make it rain for days. You tear my heart out, and you put it back in place. We take our feelings and hide them in bottles, just like the moonlight, they're gone by tomorrow. So will you love me? When you're sober, will you need me? All hungover, if you're lonely, I'll come over. I'll keep dreaming till it's over. 'Cause you don't love me when you're sober. No good at staying, no good at letting go. Barely surviving through all these highs and lows. Caught in a dead end, where did we begin? So we can go back to you slow dancing with me. So will you love me? When you're sober, will you need me? All hungover, if you're lonely, I'll come over. I'll keep dreaming till it's over. 'Cause you don't love me when you're sober.
Not true.
Tell me I've been lied to. Crying isn't like you. Ooh. What the hell did I do? Never been the type to let someone see right through. Ooh. What the hell did I do? Maybe won't you take me back? Say you were trying to make me laugh, and nothing has to change today. You didn't mean to say I love you. I love you. And I don't. There's nothing you can do or say. I can't escape the way I love you. And I don't want to. But I love you.
Garageland on Cruinniú and on RTE 2XM.
Cairn é an rud is tábhacht nar a bhíonn tú ag lyric duine nua don bhanna ceo.
I think the most important thing for me with experience now and looking back and having been in a lot of bands, I think you have to get on with the person first and foremost. there might be competition between you, but competitiveness, that's absolutely fine. But like deep down, you have to get on with each other because you're going to be spending a lot of time in the back of the van doing and waiting around and hanging around. It's that thing that the drummer from the Rolling Stones said, Charlie Watts, you know, he said, like, I've been 50 years a musician, and I think he said like 35 years of that has just been hanging around. So it's important that the people that you're with, you get on with, and that you can, you know, vibe off each other and inspire each other. And then obviously talent's a big one. If they've got something, if they've got an ingredient that brings something really great to the band. I remember when I first met Mick Lennox, the bass player, the original bass player from Power of Dreams. He had this musicality and ability that really was inspiring for me as a writer. And when he joined the band, I started writing loads of songs because I knew I was going to bring it into the rehearsal room and he was going to take it somewhere I really liked. So that's where that thing of being inspired. What else is there? Just, I'd say that. And also, you know, somebody that's in it for the long haul. I think bands have really got to kind of stick with it and evolve. You know, it's all the great bands have stayed together over a long period of time and managed to, you know, somehow get through. So yeah, sticking together as a band is super important, and creating a gang mentality. And there's nothing better than being on the road and when you're a young band and, you know, touring. And you know, it's, you know, you different town every night. It's fantastic. It's amazing.
I don't know where I parked the car. Too much of the London thrills. Watching another boring pop star on a billboard up on Muswell Hill. Flamingo dancing, trying to impress. You're the only one I trust. I will take a black cab. They always seem to take me home. Help me straighten up, I'm bleeding. Leave me cold if that's what you need to do it. Do it, 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 do it. Thought I'd never lost myself. Thought I had it figured out. You only learn by doing well. Then you take the easy way out. The network is on the prowl. Too much of the free champagne. Dialogue you've heard so often. You can reel it up verbatim.
And we are here today with Billy McGuinness from Aslan.
So, Billy, have you ever met any of your heroes?
Oh, yeah. Of course we have. Of course we have. I mean, we were very lucky, very fortunate. As you know, we're big, big David Bowie fans. And I remember we were in recording Feel No Shame in Westland Studios. And our manager came in and said, Bowie is playing at Slane. And we said, look, I don't care what you ever get for us. He says, you have to get us on that bill. And it was a stroke of luck. Bowie had just signed with EMI Records and we had just signed with EMI. So it was great for us to be performing at Slane. But although we didn't get to meet Bowie, there was a guitarist called Peter Frampton and Carlos Alomar they were in Bowie's band at the time. And myself and Joe got to meet them, which was absolutely out of this world. They actually stood at the side of the stage while we were performing. It was brilliant. It was great. Now, these are like legendary guitarists. I know you probably, people that are listening to this wouldn't know about Peter Frampton or Carlos Alomar, but check them out. Peter Frampton used to use this, when he went solo, he used to use this tube guitar. Wah, 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 wah. It was like a wah-wah, but it was a tube on the mic. It was just amazing. He did number one album in America with that album. But, and then of course, U2. Now, we did get to meet Bono, of course, and the lads. And to me, the work ethic that they have is second to none. And if you want to know what a band should be like working, just look at U2. And when you think that those guys are multi-millionaires, and yet the Edge is in the studio 5-6 days a week, Larry will be in there, Adam will be in there, Bono will be all over the place, but he's doing good work for charity this and that. But the work ethic they have, the minute they release an album, they're working on the next one. And their shows are absolutely phenomenal. And when Christy was sick, it was Bono and Googie. Googie used to play in a band called the Virgin Prunes. They called up to Christy, and Bono brought in his laptop, and Christy was in a wheelchair at that time. And he was showing the lyrics for the new album, and they were chatting about the old days and how do we get that vinegar? How do we only get that vinegar back where we didn't care and we just went for it? And he brought Christy up a book of poetry by Seamus Heaney. Now, he didn't have to do that, do you know what I mean? But it kind of shows, I know he gets an awful slagging from the Irish people. And I don't know why, I really don't know why. I'm very proud of what they've done. They put Ireland on the map. Because if you go back to the 80s, when U2 broke, every record company in the UK had an Irish act on their label. You had Light a Big Fire, they were on Siren. You had Cactus World News, they were on MCA. You had Intuanua, were on Virgin. Aslan were on EMI. You had Blue in Heaven. You had feckin', there was bands. It was like Liverpool, Beatlemania. Every week you'd have a showcase where 15, 20 A&R men would be over. They were all looking for the next U2. They were never going to find the next U2 because U2 were phenomenal. They were just once off, phenomenal. But I'm very proud that they're the best. They are still the biggest and the best rock and roll band, and they're from Dublin. And, you know, if you go back to the 80s when they formed Mother Records, they tried to help Irish bands get a deal by giving them the chance to release on a major label, which was Mother. And it worked quite a lot of the times. Cactus World News, it worked. Intuanua, it worked. So they were heroes of mine. They were big heroes. And yeah, I've gotten to meet them several times now at this stage. And I can't say enough good things about them. Okay, so you've written your song and you're about to perform it live. That's the true test of when you find out if the song is any good or not. And a simple rule that we have, I don't know if this works for other bands, but when we perform the song, we're looking out at the audience, especially when we're performing it for the first time. So we perform it, and when we get to the chorus, if people start going to the toilet, going to the jacks, or they're going to the bar to get a drink, there's something wrong with the chorus. We'll say, Jesus, the chorus, look, they all legged it. They went to the bar, they started chatting. So we will take that song back into rehearsal and work on making the chorus better or making the song better. So for us, the proof for the pudding is when you perform it live, and I mean, if you can get them singing along to the chorus, well, then it's a win-win. That's when we wrote Crazy World, I remember we didn't think it was on an album called Goodbye Charlie Moonhead, and we thought like Rain Man was a better single. We thought Where's the Sun was a better single. We didn't rate Crazy World at all. So, and when we started digging it, after it picked up some radio play and people started singing the chorus back to us, that's just like, then you know, you really know you have a great song, you know? And we're very fortunate that we have written two really good songs. One is This Is and one is Crazy World. No matter where we are, when we perform them songs, the audience just naturally sing back. And that to me is the sign of a great song, of a great song.
Thanks, Billy McGuinness and Craig Walker. In that section, we also had music from Amber Lily Marr in North County, Dublin, and Julia Pierce in Glenageary. Now we're going to go across to Alexandra Vossa in Rathcoole.
Well, sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water. And I think of all the things, what you're doing, and in my head I paint a picture. Cause since I've come on home, all my body's been a mess. And I miss your ginger hair and the way you let you dress. Won't you come on over? Stop making a fool out of me. Why won't you come on over, baby? Go to jail, put your house up on for sale. Did you get a good lawyer? I hope you didn't catch a 10. I hope you found the right man who fixed it for ya. Are you shopping anywhere? Change the color of your hair. Are you still busy? Did you have to get a fine? If you was dodging all the time, are you still dizzy? Cause since I've come on home, well, my body's been a mess. And I miss your ginger hair and the way you left your dress. Won't you come on over? Stop making a fool out of me. Why won't you come on over, Valerie? Sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water. And I think of all the things what you're doing. In my head, I paint a picture. Cause since I've come on home, well, my body's been a mess. And I miss your ginger hair and the way you like to dress. Won't you come on over? Stop making a fool out of me. Why won't you come on over, baby? Baby. 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 Baby.
Home gone alligator, see you later. Gotta hit the road, gotta hit the road. Something changed the atmosphere. Architecture unfamiliar, I could get used to this. Time flies by in the yellow and green. Stick around and you'll see what I mean. There's a mountain top that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. We're south of the equator, navigator. Gotta hit the road, gotta hit the road. Deep sea, I've been around the clock. Bikini bottoms, larger tongue. I could get used to this. Time flies by in the yellow and green. Stick around and you see what I mean. There's a mountain top that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. We got two in the front, and two in the back. We're sailing along and we don't look back, 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 back. Top, back, back in the yellow and green. Stick around and you'll see what I mean. There's a mountain top that I'm dreaming of. If you need me, you know where I'll be. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone. I'll be riding shotgun underneath the hot sun, feeling like a someone, 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 someone. Oh yeah, I'm feeling like a someone. I'm feeling like a someone.
Hi, I'm Lily Foley.
And I'm Jean Foley, and we're going to be singing PAA Zoo,
accompanied by the very talented Noel O'Sullivan and Alwyn Trent.
Amber Lily Marr, and I'm loving lockdown in Clondalkin because it made me realise to appreciate the little things in life. I made this recording how I make every single one of my other recordings, which is on my microphone and my laptop.
Somebody loved me, everything.
every hour spent together lives within my heart. And when she was sad, I was there to dry her tears. And when she was happy, so was I. When she loved me, through the summer,
pressed in his palms, elbows red upon the cherry oak. Gift from dad and mom on their anniversary. 2001, he's a veteran of a war already won. I'm just sitting in this feeling, well, he's just sitting on his ass. But if you contemplate your future, you'll weaponize your past. You're both the water in your lifeboat, swimming awful fast. It's only love if every conversation lasts.
Sweet baby ocean, I am loving lockdown in Dublin as I've been able to sing, dance and do what I love. I've recorded two songs in my bedroom and this song is a cover of Olivia Rodrigo's new song called Good For You. I hope you enjoy it.
Good for you, I guess you moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world? Good for you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. I guess that therapist I found for you, she really helped. Now you can be a better man for your brand new girl. And good for you, you look happy and healthy. Not me, if you ever cared to ask. Good for you, you're doing great up there without me. Baby, gotta wish that I could do that. Have lost my mind, I've spent the night crying. You're getting everything you want. You got a new car and your career's really taking off. It's like we never even happened, baby. What is up with that? And good for you, it's like you never even met me. Remember when you swore to God I was the only person who ever got you? Well, screw that and screw you. You will never have to hurt the way you know that I do. And good for you, you look happy and healthy. Not me, if you ever cared to ask. Good for you, you're doing great up there without me. Baby, gotta wish that I could do that. I've lost my mind, I've spent the night crying on the floor of my bathroom. You're so unaffected, really don't get it. I guess good for you. Maybe I'm too emotional, but your apathy's like a wound insult. Maybe I'm too emotional, or maybe you never cared at all. Maybe I'm too emotional, but your apathy's like a wound insult. Maybe I'm too emotional, or maybe you never cared at all. Not me, if you ever cared to ask. Good for you, you're doing great up there without me. Baby, like a damn sociopath. I've lost my mind, I've spent the night crying on the floor of my bathroom. You're so unaffected, really don't get it. I guess good for you. I guess you moved on really easily.
All right, we're Fuse. We're from Wicklow. We are Fuse Band X on Instagram. I'm Bobby Dowling the second. I play the guitar and I sing the songs.
I'm Daniel Anthony Murray. I do backing vocals and play the bass.
I'm Stephen Robert Captain Dowling. And I play drums.
What we most loved about lockdown is it really gave us time to get the songs down and really solidify the band as a three piece.
But I think that if we really think about it, nobody likes lockdown and we all want to do it.
Enjoy the tunes, lads.
I'm loving lockdown in Dublin because we basically managed to form a band during lockdown, which I don't think a lot of people can say they've done. I originally started the project pre-COVID, about 2 months before lockdown. I met Jake, actually online, incidentally. And then we weren't really sure if there was going to be a band. We weren't really sure if we pretty much weren't able to rehearse. And we were having chats online and sending each other demos and things like that. And then didn't really know what was happening. So the actual band formed during lockdown and during restrictions. And Jordan and Johnny came on board, and we were all sending each other demos and basically going from there. So we've managed to get our debut single out, which we've just played. And then we've loads more plans for this year as well. So that's 100% the best thing about lockdown is the formation of Don't Tell Mum.
And so how we made this video with COVID restrictions, you're allowed to go out and rehearse basically. So we're out here in Camelot Studios where we get our rehearsal in now. And That's Camelot Studios there.
There it is, mate.
And yeah, no, so we just got the phone out and we just grabbed the two guitars after just being in rehearsal there. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed it and I hope it sounds great. And congratulations to every band that's been on the Garageland team.
Cheers. Cheers. Chat you later.
My name is Connor. I'm 13, going 14 on the 10th of May, and I'm loving lockdown in Betty's Town because I live close to the beach and it just means I get to walk and walk and walk in these nice dunes with my dog, in some private areas too where you're not bothered by the public. And it means I can focus on my songwriting a lot more than I usually would be able to.
Our message for you guys is that, you know, the lockdown, although it seems so long, so stressful, so unproductive, feel like, you know, nothing's gonna happen right now, you know, ignore all of that and enjoy the lockdown. Enjoy with the ones you love, do what you love, keep yourself occupied, organize yourself, and hopefully during this after this lockdown, as soon as everything's over, you'll learn so much more than you did before, because you're actually using your time, you're making your time useful instead of just staying in bed. So I guess this is the time to get up and do something. So yeah, just a little motivation for you guys. Take care, love you.
I love lockdown in town here because I think there's great community spirit and all the neighbours, you know, met up for, you know, like walks and stuff, and just I love spending time with my family as well in lockdown. And I got to practicing a lot as well in my house, probably drove my family mad, but I really enjoyed it. And just, you know, appreciating everything, I think, definitely. And yeah, just spending time with family and friends, I think.
That's time for young people's music gets heard!
Garageland on Cruinniú and on RTE2XM.